Welcome to St. Peter School. This is your science class, and in previous class we were at the chapter number 2, that is the living organism, and we were discussing about the different characteristics which living organism bears, like reproduction, respiration, excretion, response, growth, movement. These all are the main, very important characteristics which is performed only by the living things, not by the non-living things. Okay, so today we are going to start with the new topic. So take out page number 14. We have covered the topic, a definite lifespan, that all the human beings, all the living organism has a definite lifespan, and all have a different lifespan. Okay, so okay, so some in a purple color box at the top of the page number 14, you will see in the purple color box something is very important written here. Do you know? It's just for your information. The lifespan of the giant turtle found on the Galapagos Island in the South America is about 170 year. On the other hand, the lifespan of the mayfly ranges from 1 hour to 24 hour. Okay, so see how short lifespan is having mayfly. Mayfly is a lifespan of only 1 hour to 24 hours. So within 24 hour, what happened? He will die. So very short lifespan. While the giant turtle, which is found in Galapagos Island, has a lifespan of 170 years. So how long he can live is for 170 year. So different living organism has a different lifespan. Now have a quick reading on it. Observe a honeycomb and a wall. What are they made of? Okay, so most all of we have seen how the honeycomb is arranged. It's like a wall, or you can say it's like a comb, or the मतलब जाली की तरह ये होता है. It's looking like a जाला. So you may have seen the small compartments of a honeycomb. You will see that like you can see there is a different hexagonal shape is together arranged in a honeycomb, and there is a separate compartment. You can count all the hexagons. It is arranged in such a way so you can count all the hexagons present here, right? So these compartments are joined together to form a honeycomb, and this is together known as honeycomb. A wall has a brick. It's like arranged in a brick form. Okay, so we firmly join the bricks together. A cellular structure. Now, what we are going to discuss about the cellular structure. So all the living organism are made up of cell. So you will study it later on, what is cell, and I might be you have already you have already idea about this. What is cell? Cell is a, like you can say, unit part of the body, that is called cell. And cell, there are different two types of cell. One is plant cell, and another is animal cell. There is a difference between the cell structure of animal cell and plant cell, so you will study it later on. Living things are made up of small units, that is called cell. All the actions and processes in the bodies of living things are brought about with the help of these microscopic cells. So when you will see under the microscope, you might be see what is the structure of cell. Some living things are made up of single cell, and these are called unicellular organism. So on the basis of cellular structure, different types of living organism is characterized. For example, if the living organism is made up of single cell, that is called unicellular organism, and the example is amoeba. Okay. On the other hand, the living organism that are made up of many cells are called multicellular organisms. For like us, we are made up of multicellular, so we are multicellular organism. But unicellular example are amoeba, paramecium. These are made up of only one cell. Okay. So the amoeba and the some other organism are unicellular, while man, cow, house, cockroach, elephants, banyan tree, the onion plant, etc. All the plants and the human beings are made up of multicellular structure. Okay. All the characteristics of living things are seen in every cell of living thing, whether it is unicellular and the multicellular. So very important characteristics, living organism are made up of cell. Non-living things are not made up of cell. Living things are made up of cell, and cellular structure is the main characteristics of living things. So even though the number of cells may vary, for example, like suppose somebody's died, so how we will understand this, that if something is died, he will not perform respiration, excretion, and any type of function of living organism. But how can we test when we dissect that body, we will get a cellular structure, multicellular structure, and it will show that it is a type of living organism. Okay, so living cellular structure is the main characteristics of living thing. Now, institute at work, the institute that work for the survey and conservation of various plants and animals in different part of India is called Botanical Survey of India. It is found in 1890, and the Geological Survey of India 1916 respectively. So Botanical Survey is made for the plant survey and Geological Survey is made for the animal survey. In case you find an unfamiliar plant or animal in your surrounding, you can communicate with these institutes to obtain more information about it. So institute of at work, how it's working, it has two different parts. One is botanical survey, one is zoological survey. So every time if there is something new occurs in a living creatures, we used to inform there. So you can also be a part of this. If you find something very new creatures in your locality, you can inform Geological Survey or the Botanical Survey. Now, useful living things. Plants are used. Can you tell in what way are the plants and animals useful to us? Now we are going to discuss about what is the use. What is the use of? Is there any use of living things? Plants are used for household as well as industrial purpose. For example, fenugreek, methi, potato, okra, bhindi, apple, banana are used as a food, while vesaka and this the scientific name is Edulcia, and Hirada, Behara, asparagus are used in medicines. So these are all are herbs which is used as a medicines, while some lots of vegetables and fruits are the plant products which we use for our food. And the lots of the plants, furniture, plants parts are used for the furniture also. Animals are also useful to us. Dogs, cats, cows, buffaloes are kept for domestic uses. Fish, sheep, fowl are used as the food, while animals like horses, oxen, camel prove useful in various occupations. So previously what happens, horses and oxen, even now also most of the area oxen and horses are used as the transport area, right? Or in the grain field. Yes, so the earthworm is very useful in agriculture. Even the earthworm, very small insect, is also very important for the agriculture. So in this way, plants and animals are useful to us. These are the useful characteristics of living things like plants and animals. Harmful living things. There are also some harmful living things. Some animals and plants around us are harmful to man. For example, mosquitoes and flies spread disease. We all know that due to mosquitoes, most of the people suffer from dengue or the malaria. So these are harmful insects. Cockroaches, mice, rats destroy our food. Yes, we don't like to have cockroach, mice, or rats in our house. They used to spoil our food. Lice, ticks also spread disease. And the bites of some poisonous lizards, spiders, snakers, and scorpions can even cause death. These lizards and these scorpions are like having a poisonous. These are poisonous, so it may cause death to some us. If wild elephants enter human settlement, they cause a lot of destruction. So if the like elephant, wild elephant is very big in size. So if it enters into a human being's land, what happen? They might destruct some everything. Some plants too can be harmful. So plants are also some plants are also harmful. So some plants too can be harmful, as for example the dodder, parasitium, and the other weeds. So these are बोलते इसको जंगली प्लांट, और यू कैन से जड़ी बूटी ऐसे बोलते हैं. सो पॉड्स एंड द नेटल पॉड्स ऑफ द नेटल कोलोकेशिया लीव्स काउज ईचिंग. सो दिस इज अ टिपिकल प्लांट विच यू यूज टू काउज ईचिंग. इफ यू विल टच दोज दीज प्लांट्स, यू विल फील ईचिंग इन योर बॉडी. प्लांट्स लाइक ओलियंडर, Lantana have a strong odors. Datura plant is poisonous. Datura is very common. It is poisonous in nature. Uncontrolled growth of fungi and algae in water pollutes drinking water and may cause the spread of disease. When you used to store water for a long time in a container, and if you see the formation of algae inside the bottle, that is very like harmful for our health. So in this way, some plants and some animals are useful and some are non-useful to us. In next class, we will discuss with the next topic. Next topic that is. Okay, so I think we have already almost covered the topic. Only the wild animals. So let's cover that topic also. So wild animals that hunt other animals for food are called predators. For example, tiger, lion, wolves, leopard. Sometimes due to deforestation, such animals enter human settlements in search of food and may kill the domestic animals or the people. So these are not known as the harmful animals because they feed on the small animals. But however, it is harmful to some animals, right? So it is like you can say इनकी मजबूरी होती है उनको हंट करना, but it is not harmful. But yet wild animals are harmful to those animals. Okay? So watch TV channels such as National Geographic Discovery and collect information regarding various plants and animals found in our surrounding. Have a class discussion. Okay, so when we will at the class, we will discuss all this about the different types of plants and animals which is found in nature. So we have already covered with the chapter. In next class, we will discuss about the question and answer and some very important points. Okay, so till the time, take care and bye-bye.